Greetings, this is LGR Plays, and this is Thunderwolves! A fantastically cheesy name for actually a pretty cheesy game. I mean, seriously, this is like half and half serious. I mean, you look at the right-hand side of the screen, and it looks kind of sort of serious. And then you look at the left side over here, I mean, that's not serious at all. I mean, that font? No. That screams, I am not exactly serious. Anyway, this is a game that came out on May 15th, 2013 for PC. It's on Steam right now. Maybe other places, I don't know. It's $15, and it's by Most Wanted Entertainment. And it's a single-player and co-op game. Local co-op, at least. We're going to be playing single-player here. Local co-op is pretty much the same thing. It's just, well, you have two people doing the same missions. So yeah, let's go into single-player. Of course, you have a tutorial to go through. We're not going to do that. Yeah, let's just continue the game and start on Mission 2, which is the actual first mission of the game. I have some difficulty to set here. I'm going to put it on casual because I don't want to die terribly during this. Some controls to set. Unfortunately, you cannot customize the controls, but you can select either keyboard and mouse or gamepad. And also, if you unlock skins and helicopters, you can switch them around here, but I don't have any unlocked, so let's just go ahead and play.
Hey, what's up, kid? I've been thinking, what exactly do our clients want? What does disable the plant really mean?
This ain't rocket science, kid. It's just rockets.
There it is.
It is. Just rockets indeed. Alright, so as you can see here, it's a helicopter shooter. Kind of in the vein of games like Jungle Strike, Nuclear Strike, Desert Strike, Seek and Destroy even, on the Amiga and PC. Very much games like that. But it's not with that isometric or top-down view. It's more of a... You know, it actually kind of reminds me of the behind-the-shoulder third-person shooter view from Transformers Fall of Cybertron, like where you would transform into one of the helicopter-y kind of forms. Yeah, it sort of controls a bit like that. Which, you know, that's cool by me, because this is it's a different variation on that old arcade helicopter shooter formula. You're just going around shooting the crap out of stuff with guns and rockets, and that's about it. You have objectives and there's a story, but, you know, it's just, it's stupid, it's over the top, there's no real reason to pay attention to any of that. Unless you just want to. And it's not so over the top that it goes into, like, Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon territory, either. It's really, oh crap. Man, these guys are shooting the crap out of me with rockets. I do have flares, but I don't know if they'll work against ground units like this. Anyway. Yeah, I don't remember what I was saying. You can change altitude here. That is another control method to, you know, methodize. I don't know. But for some reason, I can't go very high, it seems, in this level. So yeah, it does restrict you quite a bit as to what you can do. It's not like a big open world, but you just have these arenas to go and shoot the crap out of stuff in. Speaking of shooting the crap out of stuff, I'm gonna shoot this train. Yeah. No more freight for you guys. Didn't need to, but you can, so why not? A little bit of overkill there. But you know what? That's cool, because honestly, this game is overkill at times. Like, It gets pretty intense. I think we'll see a little bit later in this level. This is actually pretty tame.
Don't worry, cowboy. I've got plenty more to keep you busy. Proceed to the next target area and engage all hostile units.
Seek and destroy.
Seek and destroy indeed.
Hang on. We're going in weapons hot.
Alright, so here we've got a rail shooter mode that it goes into, and it does go back and forth between these kind of sections. You'll either be controlling the gun on the helicopter, or like a turret, or something along these lines. So it does mix things up a little bit here and there. It's very much an arcade game, through and through. I mean, there's points, there's if you put the high, the expert difficulty, yeah, you got arcade difficulty. Right here, it's honestly just straightforward. I'm just clicking on things until they blow up, which is, you know, it's fun to a degree, but I do prefer the higher difficulties when I'm actually playing it. Of course, here I'm just trying to show what the game looks like. Yeah, hellfire and hot lead. Oh man, yeah, I would have friggin' loved this kind of thing as a kid. I do like it now, but it's a little limited, I guess, for my tastes nowadays, especially for $15. $15 may be just a tad much. Oh crap, we got a helicopter. This is gonna be interesting. $15 may be a tad much, depending on what you're looking for. I still don't think it's an unfair price at all, but from what I've heard, the game is only a few hours long, and while it's certainly an action-packed, crazy few hours, I would just prefer maybe like $10 or something dollars, but you know, that's a minor thing, and that's going to be very much personal too, so whatever. Yeah, it's certainly not a bad game by any means. There's just a few minor little things that make me say, maybe not 15. Like, there's like no graphics options like at all. For some reason, it locks itself to like a 1610 resolution on my monitor, even though I'm using it on a 16:9 for this. I don't know. Can't customize the controls. Just little things like that. And seeing as it's like not, as far as I know, a console conversion, and I don't know what the deal is, but hey, whatever. And I also don't think you can invert the controls, which I think that's going to really piss off some people. Maybe that'll be patched in. It probably will be. But yeah, at the moment, cannot be done that I can find. It is satisfying to blow these things up. Music's cool too, I guess. You know, it's pretty generic rock, but it's good stuff. And it's certainly fitting for the theme of the game of just like, yeah, man, we're killing stuff in the early 90s. So sweet.
Anything new on that signal? Wolf 1, there's some kind of structure or facility under the plant. Whatever it is, it's even too deep for a daisy cutter. So what's the plan there? If you can locate an entrance to the structure, we'll send in a drone.
A drone? How?
No, no, blister. Above my pay grade.
Raptor pushing deck 2!
Yeah, I think we get to actually control the drone here in a bit, which is, that's the same thing as controlling a helicopter, so yeah. Just in more cramped spaces. Honestly, this is pretty much it. I don't know if we'll get to it later in this mission, but actually, we kind of do. There is some stuff later where you'll have to like pick up POWs and just people that just need rescuing. I hate that return to mission area thing, too. I wish it would just let you fly around, but whatever. Yeah, there's people that need rescuing. There's cargo you'll need to pick up. It's not exactly like Seek and Destroy, though, where you're picking up resources. You're just picking up random cargo that it tells you to. At least that's all I've seen so far. Yeah, drone time!
We've located the entrance. It's all clear.
Copy, Wolf 1. The drone is on its way.
It looks like a damn toy!
I would think a man-child such as yourself would be more excited about a toy.
I'm excited! Let's do this! yeah, this is cool. I think it's awesome how it does sort of just mix things up as far as the environments and everything. This is... it's all of a sudden a corridor shooter with helicopter drones. So, it has its variety and has its moments. And every mission so far that I've played, which isn't very many, but... yeah, it's been cool because it does at least change up the setting and really what you need to do, although it basically all just comes down to avoid getting shot and shoot everything that glows red, so... really, really simple. But at the same time, man, Ain't nothing wrong with that. Arcade goodness. I like it. And with co-op, too, that's actually pretty interesting, because you'll have one player, depending on what you're doing, you'll have one player, like, flying, and the other player doing, like, guns and rockets, or maybe just rockets and, like, locking on or something. It depends on what you're doing, but this will be pretty fun co-op, I think. Keep shooting at those mission markers, thinking that's something. Oh, it's glowing so white. No, that's just where I'm supposed to go. Controls are pretty intuitive too, at least for me. I don't rely on the inversion thing or anything like that for this kind of shooter. Like, if I'm in a cockpit, I do, but third person, I prefer not inverted at all, which that's what this is. So it works. Everything's pretty much just mapped to WASD. You got Q and E for going up and down. F sets off flares. Hold down Alt to like speed up or slow down. Yeah, it's pretty simple stuff. Not too many things to learn. Ouch. Okay, I seriously need to stop running into everything. And yet I keep doing it. My apologies to the stalactites.
It's hard to miss.
Okay, Wolf One. Retrieve the crate. Then exfil the hell out of there.
Alright, here we go. We got some cargo. Pick that up. Good stuff. Yeah, we can get out of here. Or not. Oh, nice. Well, we have some armor to deal with, apparently. That'll be fun. Nice cramped space. Use the rocks as covers. Gotcha. Yay, boss battles. Thanks, rocks. You rock as cover. Unfortunately ran out of my own rockets. That kind of sucks. Flare time! Whatever, we'll just wear him down. Yeah! Electric explosions with a helicopter flying through it. Oh yeah, that's delightfully cheesy. Yay, got stars! Bronze ones, because I'm a filthy casual when making these videos. Anyway, oh, sweet, new chopper. That's pretty much it for Thunder Wolves. If we wanted to, we can go and do another one and select the other chopper, which, you know, there's different abilities, they have different weapons. Yeah, that's cool. But anyway, that's the game. Again, $15. I would say it's worth it if you're into these kind of things, because really it's not bad. And you can excuse some of the lack of customization, but it's good stuff. Thanks for watching.